healthy people. Dr. Mike here with Complete Wellness. I have Mike Swift, former college football player and now strength and conditioning coach. And we're going to go ahead and explain to you what anterior pelvic tilt is, how to correct it or prevent it, and we're going to give you some daily exercises that you can do at home to help prevent and correct this. So anterior pelvic tilt, we're going to demonstrate what that looks like. And so if we look at Mike from the side, his normal stance, he has pretty good neutral pelvic tilt. But if you take his pelvis and you shift it anteriorly or forward, you're going to see that his stomach sticks out and his butt sticks back. And what happens over time is due to this, it can continually get worse because the abs get weak, the glutes get weak, and on the other side, the back muscles here, the erector spinae and the hip flexors, they're gonna get tight over time. So Mike's been holding this position for about a minute now. So how does it feel?
Pretty rough on my lower back. Honestly, it's really uncomfortable position to be in.
Yeah, you can stop. So over time, this is what happens. And because people are sitting, about 90% of Americans sit at their job, usually glued to the computer screen, but over time, the back just gets really, really sore, and it's just a very uncomfortable position. One of the causes of anterior pelvic tilt is physical inactivity. Foot pronation is another cause of anterior pelvic tilt, where the feet actually roll in, the arches are lost, and it translates up into the knees, the hips, and the pelvis. Improper strength training is another main cause of anterior pelvic tilt. Here are a few videos describing and showing you how this happens. Now Mike's gonna demonstrate the proper way to do a deadlift. Back's gonna be straight. He's gonna be looking up, big chest, straight up. Now Mike's gonna do a deadlift with a proper form, and he's gonna try not to hurt himself for this one. But what you're gonna see as he demonstrates this, go ahead Mike, is he's gonna really activate his erector spinae, and he's gonna lead with his hip flexors first and his quads. But you're gonna notice a big arch in his back. That is not ideal. So, yeah, doesn't feel good.
No.
Yeah. Less common cause would be genetic predisposition where you're born with anterior pelvic tilt. And the number one cause, the most prevalent thing that causes anterior pelvic tilt by far, is sitting for prolonged periods of time. So the first exercise we're going to go over is standing pelvic tilts. So again, if you're trying to correct an anterior pelvic tilt, you want to actually think about posteriorly tilting it during the exercises. So Mike is going to activate his glutes, his core, and you can see by doing that, it's actually straightening out the erector spinae muscles and the hip flexors. Yep, so you want to do that sets of 10. Hold it for about 2-3 seconds. Yep. And it looks easy, but you actually will feel this. Because you're actually gonna really need to focus on activating that with your brain, just activating those muscles. Now we're gonna demonstrate lying pelvic tilts. So you'll be able to see under here, with anterior pelvic tilt this way, I'll be able to put my hand underneath his back just like this. And how you want to think about doing this is he's going to want to just squish my hand with his back. Exactly, yep. So there's a lot of pressure there. I'm just going to close that curvature in the low back. Yep. Same thing as standing. As far as repetitions, you're going to do 10. You're going to hold it for about 2-3 seconds each time. Good job. Yep. And this is a really easy one. You can do this one anywhere. So foam rolling the hip flexor muscles, rectus femoris, iliopsoas, is also really important. It's going to allow for an easier stretch. And so literally Mike's just laying on this and rocking forward and backward right along his hip flexors. And for a lot of you, this is going to be very sensitive because they're so tight. So you can see he's kind of doing a little bit of a push-up stance or a plank stance to just take a little bit of the pressure off of there. And the more that you do it, the easier it's going to get and the less sore it's going to be. But he's sore because he lifts a lot, he's sore all the time anyways. So we're going to do body weight hip thrusts. And again, you're going to want to activate abs and glutes. It's always going to be abs and glutes, abs and glutes. So as he does a hip thrust, his core and his glutes are going to be tight. He's going to be really focused on that. Hold it for a couple seconds, then go back down. So as he's doing the hip thrust, he's going to think about rotating his pelvis backwards, activating the core, activating the glutes, and squeezing as hard as he can while he's doing this. So Mike's going to demonstrate a normal plank. And in a normal plank, the feet are pretty close together. He's actually able to anteriorly pelvic tilt like this. And so planks are good, but this isn't what you want to do for these exercises. Now he's going to demonstrate an RKC plank. Feet are out wider. Actually, his butt's up a little bit more. He's actually able to activate his glutes and his core a little bit more in this position, making sure that he's holding his hands in front of him on his elbows. And so you want to hold this for about as long as you can comfortably and then rest. So now Mike's going to demonstrate a lunge stretch. And remember, the tighter your hip flexors are going to be, it's going to roll your pelvis forward more. And so we're going to actually be stretching that out by doing this lunge stretch. So Mike's going to put his foot out and his knee is going to bend forward. He's going to feel a stretch right through here. And even to make that a little bit harder, he's going to lift his arm up and then twist towards. So he's going to elongate that anterior chain right there and the hip flexors. You want to hold that for about 10 seconds. Up to 30 seconds. So this exercise is going to demonstrate how to stretch your rectus femoris muscle. The lunge stretch is similar to this. It's going to hit more of your iliopsoas muscle. And so you can use a bench, you can use a couch, a chair. It's hard to actually grab your foot, but some people it's easier if you're more flexible. But what Mike's gonna do is in this position, he can actually lean forward a little bit more. And again, he's gonna stretch the hip flexors right there. And if he wants to, if that gets a little bit easier the more that he does this, then he can move his knee back a little bit closer to the bench, which will then make it a little bit harder and get a little bit better stretch in there. How's that feel?
Feel it.
Another wonderful way to activate your glute muscles is Mike is wearing a band right here. He's actually in a wide stance for a half squat or a quarter squat. And what he's gonna do is simply just rotate his legs in an external rotation. He's gonna internally rotate his hips as he's externally rotating his legs. And that is activating his glutes. And so you're just gonna keep doing that for about 10 to 20 reps. And you don't need a super heavy band for this to activate these muscles. It's also super important to do before or squatting heavy. Any major squatting activity, you wanna activate your glutes. And not just your glute max, but your medius and a lot of the rotators. So to recap, anterior pelvic tilt is a very common thing that affects so many people. We see it, whether it's in our office or with strength and conditioning, it affects a lot of people. So the routine that you want to do is, so number one, you want a foam roll to start to just activate and loosen up the hip flexors. You want to do that for about 2 to 5 minutes, somewhere in there. For more advanced people, definitely put in the time for the 5 minutes every time. Next, you want to do standing pelvic tilts. You're going to do 10 reps of that. Then you're going to move to the floor. You're going to do lying pelvic tilts. You do 10 reps of that. Then you're going to do hip thrusters. You're going to do 3 sets of 10 repetitions on that exercise. Then you move on to the RKC planks. So for that one, you want to do about 2 to 3 repetitions and hold it for as long as you can activate your abs and your glutes. Next, you move into the lunge exercise. You want to do about 2 reps of that. And you want to hold that for about 10 to up to 30 seconds at a time. Then you're going to do your rectus femoris stretch with your leg up, either holding it or on a fixed object like a bench or a couch or a chair. And you're going to do that the same. You do that for about 10 to up to 30 seconds with that. And then lastly, to activate the glutes, you're going to do the banded squat, you're gonna hold that, and you're gonna rotate your knees out and do that 2 to 3 times, and you should be good to go. You wanna do this routine about 4 to 5 days a week to really get used to this. You can do this every single day to correct anterior pelvic tilt. All right guys, thanks for watching this video. If you have any questions about anterior pelvic tilt, or you have any ideas for further topics that you'd like for us to cover, please put that in the comment section. If you like this video, go ahead and smash that like button, and we will see you guys at the next video.
Smash that like button.
Nice.